Now I'm back with a clean palette. So let's just, here's a bit of a red, more black. More black, I don't know. Touch of a green, very small. Touch of a yellow. Okay, this is pretty nice. Again, I will load this just like this. Let's start from here. So this is just a rough, very rough shape. How this will end up looking. Okay, now what I really care about is these peaks. Let me zoom there. So I decided on this side will go more up. Now for this one we'll use this brush we used before. I will lift these small parts up. You can even dip this into this color and I just cleaned it a little bit more. Don't worry if this is not too much of a brown. You can add a bit of a red into this. Maybe even black. Just to get some land area. If you think that there is somewhere too much color, just grab, pull, clean, and repeat. Now, as we can see, let's just do this color. Oh. I just add a ton of white. Okay, maybe touch of black again. To appear more gray. We'll make a slide. We go back in here. We'll add a texture. Okay. Now let's try to do the same thing on the other side. Just like this, or we can change a bit. So again, black, red. Fairly mixed in, touch of blue, maybe a bit more, yellow, touch of a green. You can compare it. Okay, so it's a little bit more dark. I will dull it with this one. Now it's good. So with this yellow paint, Now in this part is a little bit tricky because I have here a piece of wood and I don't have a full access to the canvas. Okay, now I just fill this up. I'll bring the brightness up. Okay. The same as before. Grab and pull. Now let's use this color, this highlight one. Now, this is pretty much a very slick part of the painting, so I will remove a part of it. Same on the other one. Now, let's do a grass series. So here's this yellow medium. Very nice color. And a touch of a green. Touch of ochre, just a bit. I hope you can see this. Okay. Just do something like this. Very easy, just tapping by the edge. Not hard, easy, very easy. If you think that your brush is dirty, like here, just clean it and continue. That's easy. Clean your brush every time when you feel that. Sorry for the shaking. Okay, there's our loaded brush. Clean it, and now we're just tapping, take it back, and we'll blend this so we can't see the background, like here. On the other side. Okay. Let's just go to the other side. Now we will do exact same thing. Load the brush again. Oh. I just clean this up a bit. This is very important, so your yellow and whatever color you want to put there will stick. Always thin into thick, so color will stay in place, sorry, will not turn into mud. Now a loaded brush. You go here and try to do the same thing. First of all, just sides. Clean your brush. On the edges, I recommend to put more yellow. So it will be less noticeable. Let's just make this more alive with a bit more yellow with my last yellow. Now, maybe more blending right here. Okay. Now, this scene looks nice, but it needs some trees, so let me look. Okay, so let's use just green red. Maybe more red. Okay. So now this one, this color would be done. Now, with this brush, we'll load this up by tapping first. It'll be a full of color. By tapping, I will pull. Wiggle from each side, so it will be razor blade. Like one. Cool. And this will be very straight. Now, I decided that here will be somewhere a tree. I don't know where, maybe. Somewhere here. Okay. Now, all of it cares about now is top. The top is nice straight. And the same we'll do right in here. And for these two, use this sap green, small touch of a blue, very small. Maybe a bit of a more black. Very dark. Now what we do, just can do something like this. Okay. The same thing we will do on the other side. Just a loaded brush. Tap. Let's add more color. You know what? Just I'll put here a small print. Right in here. Just like that. Now we will do the same thing, just in a smaller scale. Okay, if you put one big right here and small one there, it will push everything right back. Now usually forest is made of one type of tree, but this time just we'll ignore this fact and we'll do something extra right here. So this color would be used for our bark. We'll dull it with white to change the color a bit. And we'll add more red. Okay, it is a bit of a different. Maybe we could add a bit of a yellow ochre. We can do something. You know what? Just I'll put one right through here. Probably a big one. Very big place. If you feel that your brushes are good enough, you're going to work more precisely. Use a smaller one, flat. Now we have more control over what you're doing. Now we have to branch this tree up a bit. So you can do something like this. Very easy. Nothing hard. Just a steady hand. Now let's put the... Yeah, it will go through. Okay. Now we go over this very easy. And we can branch this a bit more if you want. Totally up to how you feel. very easy. And let's just give it this fella a friend. A smaller one, but a friend. Like this. Okay. Now, same thing, but the other side. Or maybe we'll keep this like it is. Yeah, only this side will we have these trees. Now we've used some of this round brush. We'll go straight into this leftover yellow, touch of a green, and we'll add there a small touch of a oil, very small. So it will stick better. Now we can test this out. Oops. Small tap. Yeah, maybe a bit of a more oil. Okay, sorry for the background noise. Always roll with your brush. Always. Let's zoom there so you can see better. Don't rub it randomly. just on the boards where it is intuitive. If you filled it up, it will look like cloud. Okay, here will be a bit of a be careful if this something like this happened. Don't worry though. Just continue. I just fill this up. Just like this. Now, this point just start working on these the details, the trees. Now let's speed things up a bit. A bit of white. Maybe a bit more. I'll blend this in. Okay, and let's do same thing right here. Let's add some bushes to the background and our grass. So for our grass, I will use this, which we use for a tree. But I will add slight amount of red. I will do something like just maybe not particular to bushes, but just the grass, a tall one. Put a small bush. Right through this tree. Just like this. Maybe one there, and maybe one will sit right in here. Now, with the help of this. But if he scratches nice and hard, this will add additional details. A very low effort. Now let's jump to the other side. Thank you. maybe this one right through here, but small plot twist, will be a more of a green. If some additional sap green, we can just now we can try to do some grass. And we'll tint that with oil. We can fill this up. Just by feeling. We can put some type of a trunk through this. Maybe like broken or not. Just look back, relax. Or maybe we can just add the additional branch, just leave it empty. It's just a fun game. For those of you who are listening right now, an accident happened 3 days back. Very sad accident. My cat got shot into head several times. He was bleeding very badly, but now he's slowly recovering. Let's put some tall grass. You put all sorts of things right here. You know what? I'll just give to this evergreen tree one friend. Because why not? And I'm a bit of a crazy right here. So goes. use the same green. I will put a bit of more oil. So let me do this real quick. Something like this happened. Don't worry. Just reload your brush. And go back. Now just leave everything as it is right now. The trees will move on. We'll use this. Handy palette knife. And white. Now let's put a water line. If you do a mistake, don't be ashamed. Now let's fill this place with a small I decided just the very small one. And we can just add the vertical lines. You can put a few of them or whole batch. Now with a clean brush we can I'll just put a few more of these. Here's an example what you want to avoid. Have a zoom there. You can see that smudge. Now we'll try to remove this. First of all, just by then we use a bit of a white. And we can call this a day. So this is a finished painting. I hope you enjoyed the process and being with me. And with that said, see you soon. Goodbye.